It's about that time of day again. My name is Joseph. Thursday evening, January the 4th. Welcome back to your nightly newsletter. We're covering crude oil, S&P, NASDAQ, gold, and euro this evening. Crude is range bound with a bull bias. Tells me to look for seller failures using the two try rule at a key reversal line down at 61.50 tomorrow morning. The S&P is bullish with a big spike in range pattern tonight, and I'm watching a key hidden channel for reliable buying opportunities on Friday morning. Speaking of Friday morning, NASDAQ is also bullish with a big spike in range pattern, so my plan is to look for buyer failures down in the support area around 65.85 tomorrow morning. Gold is bullish with a big overshoot of a key resistance level, telling me to stay patient for a two-legged pullback down into the 1320 battle zone tomorrow morning. And euro is bullish, but trading sideways into major resistance, telling me to look for buying opportunities after a deep pullback in the battle zone around 21,000 on Friday morning. Speaking of Friday, tomorrow is the first Friday of January, which means it's non-farm Friday. That tells us to expect increased volatility and some awesome trading opportunities. I've got a great newsletter in store for you guys and gals tonight with plenty of reliable trading opportunities setting up for tomorrow. And I want to remind you all to make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click that little bell icon below the video to make sure you get notified every time I post a new video. And if you really want to stay in tune with everything that is School of Trade, head over to sidewaysmarkets.com. There's a link in the description of that YouTube video and join our mailing list. Never miss another newsletter. I'll send you an email every evening when our nightly newsletter goes live. While you're here on the blog at Sideways Markets, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm always posting exclusive charts, links, and updates throughout the week. The only place to find them is by following me on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, or StockTwits. Speaking of charts, how easy is this? You can find all the charts from tonight's video. All the charts in tonight's newsletter video, you can download those and have them ready on your computer for tomorrow. Right where it says, click here to download today's charts. And then speaking of charts, don't forget to grab that free pass. Upper right-hand corner, make sure you grab that free pass. Come out and join me as a guest in the trade room. You can grab more information and register for your free pass in the upper right-hand corner. And if you have any questions along the way, don't be afraid to hit me up on live support. I'm always here to answer your questions on the right-hand side of the website. Let's get started, guys. Got a lot to cover here for tomorrow. Tomorrow is the first Friday of the month. First Friday of the month is non-farm Friday. Been talking about this all week here so far. We've got a big news event coming out tomorrow morning. All eyes are focused on the employment number. We saw a very bullish number come out on Wednesday morning when we heard from that ADP employment report on Wednesday. And so, of course, tomorrow's employment number is expected to be quite strong as well. That definitely leads us into a situation where, because the number is expected to be so bullish tomorrow morning, it leaves us wide open for possibly some disappointment from that number not coming in as expected. Now, whenever we have that Friday non-farm payroll number, I always want to remind you to be careful before the news comes out on Friday morning, because all the big traders in the market, they have a hard time getting in and out of positions around this big news event. So a lot of traders are sitting on hands ahead of that news event, knowing that the likelihood of getting a very volatile reaction tomorrow morning is very high. So be careful tomorrow morning before the news comes out. After the news comes out at 8:30 a.m. Eastern Time, I always recommend to give it at least 5-10 minutes, because we normally get one of two scenarios. If the number tomorrow comes out within expectations, it'll probably be too slow to trade. You know, in other words, if we get what everyone's expecting tomorrow morning, the market tends to have kind of a lazy feeling to it for a few minutes after that number comes out. So give it some time. But watch out. If the number comes out higher or lower than expectations, and again, as I mentioned earlier, because the expectations are so high for tomorrow's number, if anything comes in below that expectation, we're probably going to see quite a volatile reaction to it as traders Warriors have to react and put on plan B, right, for what they had on earlier this week. If that happens, it'll probably be a little bit too fast to trade, a little bit too volatile, a little bit too illiquid to trade shortly after that news number comes out, right, tomorrow morning. So, as I said earlier, I always recommend be careful before the news, right, because the big whales in the market, they're not going to have very big positions. They're not going to be entering new positions ahead of that news because it's such a big question mark at 8:30. And then after the news comes out, whether it's within expectations or outside of expectations, the market usually moves either too slow or too fast. So give it 5 to 10 minutes, let it figure out what it wants to do, and then we'll pick up where we left off before the number came out tomorrow. Other than that, it's a Friday, so anytime we have a Friday, we always know that cutoff is going to be around 11 o'clock Eastern time. You know, I always remind you guys, Fridays are always a day where traders start taking bigger risks. And when you combine that with the lower volume that happens later in the morning, you create this environment that's really dangerous, right, for unexpected rookie traders. So big risks combined with lower volume, right, creates an illiquid environment, and it makes it difficult, right, as we go into lunchtime tomorrow. So get to it early, make that money after the news comes out tomorrow, and don't forget, we'll be in our trade room tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock Eastern time, and I hope to see you there, and we'll trade the entire strategy together. Speaking of tomorrow morning, let's jump into our charts here, and let's get some strategies put together. I'm going to start off tonight with crude oil. Then we'll go to the S&P, over to the NASDAQ, over to gold, and we'll wrap up tonight on the euro. One of the key themes of tonight are going to be hidden channels. Hidden channels are really, really common when we have spike and range patterns, and you're going to see a number of those here today. For example, crude oil is bullish but trading sideways with a range. Most people, myself included, I would call this a spike and range pattern. So I'm watching these hidden channels, right, coming up and coming down, right, for the best buying opportunities tomorrow. And I have my eyes on that 61 half reversal line, which still hasn't been tested from last night's newsletter. Starting off here tonight on the crude oil, we can see the market running higher here yesterday, pulls back, tries to retest the high, and fails to retest the high. That failure is considered one try here for the buyers. We normally will see the buyers try twice to retest their high. In a bull market, buyers will try twice to retest the high. In a bear market, sellers will try twice to retest the low. So I'm expecting to see another attempt at a lower price for a retest of that high tomorrow. At the same time, we've got some falling resistance from that lower high. I've got some rising support, right, from that higher low. And this is where we create our trading range. That's why I said earlier, you could think of this as a spike and range pattern. So we have a bull bias into a trading range. How do we want to trade that? I want to buy down at the lows, right? I'm watching the extremes of that triangle, so to speak, and looking for opportunities here, right, to buy as it comes back down into that low. At the same time, I'm taking this trend line here, projecting it up top. That creates kind of a hidden channel going higher. I'm also taking this trend line off the high, right, and popping it on down at that low, and that creates a hidden channel, right, going lower. The bulls have controls. We want to be a buyer tomorrow. Let's break this down now. What if price goes up? What if price goes down? And what if price goes sideways? Well, obviously, we'd like to see the price go lower here. And that's the point of this falling resistance, copied and pasted down to that low. I'd love to be able to use that reversal line we talked about in last night's newsletter, which we haven't seen tested yet, along with that low of this hidden channel, right? So I'd love to see us get down. Because it's a range, I'm always looking for the two try rule, one try, two try, and then back up off of that, right? Then back up off of that low. That's going to be the most reliable opportunity tomorrow morning. deep pullback, use the hidden channel, use the reversal line down in that battle zone. Plenty of space for buyers to step in now and take it back up to retest those highs. What if price goes sideways? Well, if price goes sideways, we're going to watch this as a short-term trading range. And if price goes sideways into tomorrow, obviously I'm kind of guessing as far as what this range will look like. But if it does end up going sideways here tomorrow, anytime we have a sideways range, we're always looking for one try, two try back up, one try, two try back down. So if we end up going sideways tomorrow morning, all of a sudden we become a neutral bias, right? Bulls and bears both having options there. And we'll look to fade the breakouts using the two try rule, right, on both sides of that trading range. What if price goes higher, right? What if price goes higher here? If price goes higher, this is where we have that hidden channel. This is why I wanted to add on the channel to the upside. Because if price goes higher here, we really want to be careful waiting for that pullback, right, to be a buyer from there. That's my goal here for tomorrow. The more aggressive traders, you guys can look for what I call the breakout or the fake out breakout pullback, strong move up and back down, using that high not as resistance but as support. And of course your target is going to be up to the high of that, right, of that hidden channel. The goal is to be able to get in on the way up to the hidden channel, take your profit, wait patiently for the pullback, right, and then run it from there as well. Keep in mind, we got non-farm payroll tomorrow morning at 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. So a little bit of this, well, I guess a lot of this, is depending on what happens in that time leading up to and shortly after that news comes out. Because as I mentioned earlier, a very lofty number expected for tomorrow's session. If it comes out outside or if it disappoints tomorrow, we may see this market really, or all of these markets for that matter, really take a bloodbath here because they've all been so bullish over the past few days. Speaking of bullish, how do we turn directions? How do we turn bearish here? Well, you can see the sellers, they really had a shot to grab it earlier, right? But they weren't able to hold it. We need a strong move down, hold the pullback, and go. If I can see strength, pullback, strength, we'll gladly call this a bear market. We'll use what were levels of support as resistance, and we'll look for that move, right, going back down, right, to retest that low, right? Anytime we reverse the trend direction, we always look for a move, new channel, new measured moves, right, headed back down, right, to the opposite extreme of that trading range. Spike and range pattern, bull bias, buy low, use these hidden channels, right, because anytime we have these spike and range patterns, we know that those hidden channels are going to be excellent spots for profit targets and entries in tomorrow morning's session. And don't forget, 8 o'clock Eastern time, I'll be in the trade room tomorrow morning. I expect to see you there with me, and we'll execute this strategy in real time. Let's keep moving. Now over to the S&P. The S&P is bullish with a spike and range pattern as well. This one tells me that buyers are weary of buying so high on the chart. So my plan for tomorrow is to look for buying opportunities using these hidden channels, both above and below tomorrow morning. As you can see, very similar scenario here on the E-mini S&P. Nice strong move higher, right? That nice strong move higher gives us, of course, a pullback, an attempt to retest the high. That attempt to retest the high fails. As I mentioned earlier, in a bull market, buyers will then look for a lower price to try again. One try, two tries to retest the high. And if they can't retest the high, it'll oftentimes collapse from there, basically as buyers start taking profit and they become sellers. Not a lot is different about this chart. As you can see, it looks very similar to the oil market, right? We got that falling resistance, that rising support, that creates our triangle. That triangle ultimately is traded like a trading range. With a trading range, we look to buy low in a bull market using the two try rule. One try, two try, and then back up to retest that high. I'm going to try to use that falling resistance combined down at that low. I'd like to use that, right, as a key level of support to be a buyer for tomorrow, right? If price goes sideways here, you can kind of see how this range is developing here right now, right? If it continues going sideways tomorrow, one try, two try, back up, right? Keep buying below of that range. And again, depending on what happens tomorrow morning, if we find ourselves continuing to go sideways, right? If we find ourselves, you know, 10 o'clock, 10:15, 10:30 tomorrow morning, and we're going sideways still, then we can start looking at this more as a neutral bias, right? A balanced market rather than being so bullish. And we can look for the one try, two try, right? And sell off the high, right? As of right now, it's a little bit too bullish to want to fade this move lower. But if we develop sideways tomorrow morning, right? For a little bit later on in the morning session, we can start looking for those sells off the highs, especially if we get one of my favorite patterns, and that is a crown reversal, right? Little trap high, failure, and then back down. So watch and see if they make a run for that high but fail to retest the high. That usually results in kind of a knee-jerk reaction as buyers frantically take profit and become sellers. What if price goes higher? Glad you asked. This is where we have that hidden channel again, right? That hidden channel, take that low, copy up to the high. So as we go higher here, your first goal will be getting in on the way up to that high. This obviously will depend on kind of when and where that happens, right? If it takes a little bit longer to get over there, right, then we may have some more space to use, right, on the way up to the high of that channel. The easy way, though, will be look for the price to rotate up, and then try to get that pullback, right, and look for the buying opportunities, you know, after that run up, look for that two-legged pullback and look for that buying opportunity up from there tomorrow morning, right? So kind of using that big channel, right, to plan my targets, right, for the buying opportunities going higher and planning my entries, right, down at that low tomorrow. So we know if price goes down, I want to use this hidden channel off of that low. Price goes up, I want to use that hidden channel off of the high. What else do we have here? Price goes sideways. We're looking for the two-try rule to fade the breakouts. And don't forget, all the terminology I'm using here tonight on this newsletter is all covered in our beginner, intermediate, and advanced classes here at School of Trade. You can find a link in the description of the video. How do we turn bearish? Strength, pullback, strength, right? Strength, pullback, strength. So strong move down, hold the pullback, and go. Once we start seeing this strength come through after we hold the pullback, remember, it's not enough to just get a strong move down, because that strong move down fails, then I know I'm looking for that move going back up, right, to retest the high, right? So strength, pullback, strength. Once I start seeing that pullback to the moving average, then I'm looking to see, do we get the continued strength going lower? If we do get that continued strength, then we know we're going to look for that hidden channel drawn off those lows, hidden channel drawn off those lows, and then look for a chance to sell up around, right, the top of that channel, right? We'll use what was support as resistance. We may even get a chance to use the underbelly of that, right, of that bear channel coming down, right? Don't trust this channel if price collapses, right? If price collapses, it'll collapse through that channel, right? That channel becomes almost obsolete at that point. If it collapses lower, it'll be a steeper channel. You might be able to use the underbelly of that channel, but, right, that's not the priority at that point, right? The priority will be to find that new channel going lower. The objective at that point will be to go back down, right, to retest that low. Pretty easy plan there on the S&P, and it's pretty much the same plan here on the NASDAQ. You'll see, making my job really easy here tonight. The NASDAQ also bullish with a spike in range pattern, telling me to watch for buying opportunities using those hidden channels, right, and the two-try rule tomorrow morning, right? So we get that big, strong move higher here on the NASDAQ, and you'll notice right now the buyers pulled back. They tried once to retest the high and failed, and they haven't made a new lower low yet. Usually the second try will be one try, and it'll be a lower second try. So watch for that second try at a lower price, right, below that low at 86.5. So as of right now, pretty much straightforward, right? We get that falling resistance, got that rising support. That creates your triangle. Triangles are traded like trading ranges. Trading ranges tell us to find the range, look for the breakout, use the two-try rule, one try, two try, right, and then back up into that range. So what if price goes up? What if price goes down? What if price goes sideways? Well, again, we're bullish right now, so we'd like to buy a pullback. One try, two try, down into that battle zone, right? Battle zone being the key low of the day today. And of course, the low of that pullback from yesterday evening's finishing rally. That will be if price goes lower. If price goes sideways, we have ourselves inside of a trading range. That trading range, of course, tells me let's stay focused on one try, two try, right? And then back up we go from there, right? One try, two try, and then back up from there. If we do continue to go sideways in kind of an extended period of time tomorrow, you know, if we get after 10 o'clock tomorrow, we're still going sideways here tomorrow. At that point, then we can start being a little bit more interested in the sell side off the high. Just be careful though, right? Just be careful though, getting too aggressive on selling this market, because if you haven't looked left yet, this is just a little bit bullish here over the past few days, right? So I'm not a big fan of fading those strong moves, right? I'm not a big fan of stepping in front of a freight train like that. I always recommend let it develop sideways, and then you can start thinking about dipping your toe in the water, right, to be a seller on that. And again, you can see that kind of crown reversal pattern we talked about earlier, right, that lower high here, right, look for that area right there, right, as the battle zone here up. If they fail to get above it, that's usually going to result, right, in the big collapse back down, right? So watch for that tomorrow as well. You know, again, we're kind of waiting on this news to come out tomorrow morning to see what the market wants to give us. If we go higher here, right, breakout pullback up to the high of that channel, right, breakout pullback up to the high of that channel, and then, of course, we'll look to use that top of that channel as a target, and then we'll look for that move back down to that low, maybe get a nice two-legged pullback, right, back down to that low, using that support area, or sorry, using that resistance area as support for that buy going back higher tomorrow. So again, sounding a bit like a broken record right now. A lot of the same stuff here to go over tonight. So relatively easy here for the plan for tomorrow. How to return bearish? Strength, pullback, strength, going lower, strength, pullback, strength. Find that new channel, find that level of resistance, right? Use that level of resistance, right, for your sell, going back down to retest that low. That prior month high will probably be the big target for tomorrow if those bears can grab control either before or after this big news comes out. Bull bias, buy low. Be careful trying to fade the highs here again until we start seeing more of a sideways movement tomorrow. Then we can start thinking about, right, being a seller. And again, right, the most reliable way to sell a market is when the market is bearish, right? So make sure you've got that bear mindset, or make sure you wait for a bear reversal before we start looking for, right, those bearish selling opportunities here for tomorrow. Now, we're finally kind of shrugging off a little bit of these spike and range patterns, and now we have a definite true trend, right, with a bull channel over on the gold. The yellow metal is bullish with a slight overshoot of the high of this bull channel. That tells me to stay patient for rotation back down to the lows. And my plan is to look for buying opportunities using that two-legged pullback into the battle zone for tomorrow. A couple things stand out here right now. We are three legs up on this gold chart here. Three legs up, as I always remind you, if we don't get a deep pullback, right, keep an eye on on a fourth leg higher, right? So if we don't get the pullback down to that battle zone, right, watch for a fourth leg higher, right? That'll be your, right, your fourth kind of measured move there, your fourth leg higher. So watch for that as a target, right, if we don't pull back in a two-legged pullback, right? I'm expecting, though, after three legs higher, and again, right, we get that big news tomorrow, and I should add that non-farm Friday, the non-farm payrolls number, one of the most volatile markets in the wake of that will be gold tomorrow morning. Gold and euro will always be highly susceptible to major volatile swings when it comes to news such as FOMC, non-farm payrolls, right, things like that. So be aware of that tomorrow. Gold will definitely be a market you do want to stay patient with tomorrow morning after that news comes out, because it typically is quite a volatile little bugger right after that news comes out at 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. A bit of an overshoot of the high of that bull channel. Great looking bull channel. I'd like to see a bit of an overshoot at the low. My goal right now would be to get a nice pullback, right, down to the low of the channel and back up, right, or down to that battle zone and back up from there. What if price goes up? What if price goes down? What if price goes sideways? Pretty simple here. It's bullish right now, so we'd like to see the price pull back for us. I'd like to get a nice deep two-legged pullback on this gold market, come down, get above that trend line, right, and then use that trend line for support. Oftentimes, the moving average comes over. We get a trap two-legged pullback into a failure, right, into a breakout pullback. And, of course, the target at that point is back up to retest that high, right? So you've got your two-legged pullback to support. You've got your seller failure at the moving average. You get your breakout pullback, right, as it makes that new higher high. Those will be excellent buying opportunities tomorrow if we can kind of survive through that news tomorrow morning, right, to kind of keep the chart together. The hardest part about major news events like we have tomorrow morning is that oftentimes the news comes out and it just shakes the whole thing up so badly that we have to kind of wait a little while before the market finds its balance again. And really when we start seeing some structure that we can rely on, right, some sort of support versus levels that we can rely on tomorrow. So hopefully we get that nice deep pullback into that battle zone, right, for us tomorrow. What if price goes sideways here? Price goes sideways, strong move up into a sideways range. It's a bull bias. Trading range tells me follow the direction of the bias, right? We get that bull bias. We want to be a buyer. It tells me focus on failures using the two-try rule, right? One try, two try, and then we'll look for that back up. Remember, I always like to look for that two-try rule. Look for the second try to be greater than the first try. We've talked about that a few times already, right? Usually two tries, the second one is deeper, right, than the first. And then we can look for, once we get that two-try rule, then we can start watching for that buy, right, going back up to retest the high. The objective will be to go back up and retest that high of day once again. What if price goes higher here, right? Could easily do it, right? Price goes higher, keeps grinding higher here. If we don't get a pullback, we don't get a little, right, a deep pullback for us here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to combine this channel low with one of these swings, right? So say, for example, right, find one of those prior swings there and try to get that little trap failure, right, and buy up from there, right? So if price keeps running higher tomorrow without pulling back, which is definitely possible, anything's possible, especially with a market like gold, right, I don't want to chase after it. I'm still going to keep looking for buying opportunities, but look closely at the way that I described this situation. I'm looking for a little trap low, right, because the key is we haven't seen any traps, right? There haven't been any breaks. None of these prior swings have been broken. So if we don't get a nice deep pullback, if we don't get a nice two-legged pullback, I do want to be patient and be aware that buyers are likely going to be waiting underneath those swings to be buying it right back higher here. And again, right, on that next pullback, once we get it, right, keep an eye on that fourth leg higher, right, and that'll be a great kind of runner target for you tomorrow morning. So we know if price goes up, we know if price goes down, we know if price goes sideways. How do we turn bearish? Well, first of all, we're going to have to get below this channel and most likely hold below that channel. That will be the first step, right? The first step here to reversal will likely be what I call a channel reversal. And we talked about that late in the month of December before we took off for the holiday break, right? That channel reversal, I'd like to get that channel reversal, hold off of that, right, off of that channel. And then again, it doesn't matter if we hold the low there. All that matters is what happens after we make that new lower low. Do we see buyers bail on this and all of a sudden it just sells off? If that's the case, then we want to go out, find that new hidden channel, find that high off the hidden channel, use some of these levels of resistance here, right, and then get it up so we can sell down from there, right? So that'll be the goal tomorrow. First step, hold the underbelly of that channel. Second step, get that new lower low on strength. And then third step, find that hidden channel drawing off the lows, copy and paste of the highs, right, and then look for that sell up above or around the high, right, of that channel. The objective at that point is back down to that 1307.1, right? Back down to that 1307.1. That'll be the short-term objective. And then who knows, right? Tomorrow, again, non-farm Friday, gold is usually highly susceptible to a big move on non-farm payrolls. So we might even see maybe even that 1300 tomorrow morning, right, by the time we finish up the session. Only time will tell. Speaking of which, let's finish up today's newsletter with our Euro chart. Euro is bullish with a spike in range pattern, surprise, surprise, as the buyers seem content with finishing today's session up at this double up resistance level. So my plan is to look for buying opportunities using seller failures and traps down in the battle zone support area tomorrow morning. Looking at this thing closely here tonight, we have a strong move higher, right? That strong move higher. Couple important clues here. First of all, we have a grind break that didn't test the moving average. I think that little clue at 21, you know, 21 and change, right? Right around that big round number at 21,000. Just above it is that 21,050. I really like that area as a great spot to wait for a trap. That's the first big clue. Bull channel, strong, steep, narrow bull channel, right? A very firm move to the upside that barely pulled back and barely got outside of that channel. And when it barely gets outside of that channel, it doesn't pull back to the moving average. You know, there's a lot of buy orders now, right, that are waiting here, right, for that pullback into that, right, into that battle zone that I've drawn up. At the same time, I have a possible measured move, ABCD correction, looking for that buy opportunity back up from there. And then what else do we have here? Well, they pulled back. They tried to retest the high there. That's one try, right? We'll expect them to try a second time, right, to retest the high. The objective is to get, right, up to the high of that range here for tomorrow. And with that said, I'm watching for one hidden channel. We really don't have enough for two hidden channels, right, which can be used as well tomorrow. So what if price goes up? What if price goes down? What if price goes sideways? Well, it's a bull market, so we'd like to see price pull back here. I'd love to see maybe we get a two-legged pullback off that trend line, right? Maybe we end up seeing a little bit wider, right, down in that battle zone here for tomorrow. One try, two try, failure, strength, pullback, and back up from there. Lots of different short-term patterns I can use to get into that position as long as I'm in the right spot, right? I want to be in the right location. That'll give me the best odds of success. What if price goes sideways here? You can almost kind of smell this thing going sideways, right? Moving average starting to move lower or move flat, right? You can almost kind of feel that market kind of tuckered out here right now. If it becomes a range, to triangle, triangles are traded like ranges, right? Whenever I see a range, I'm looking for one try, two try, right? Basically fade the breakout of that range. Remember, the key to a triangle, again, if it does start kind of going sideways here on us like this, right? The key to a triangle is find those extremes, get down below the extremes, right? And then back up. We go from there. I know I sound like a broken record right now, but unfortunately, that's the way it's playing out here tonight. We've got a lot of charts that are very, very similar. So I want to be buying down in that battle zone using seller failures and possibly a two-legged pullback, right, using one of these trend lines, which I kept off of here just for simplicity tonight, right, but we'll be using those tomorrow morning in our trade room. So that's if price goes sideways. What if price goes higher? This is a little bit more difficult. We talked about earlier how we'd like to be a breakout pullback up here, but there's just no space up there. You know, one of the challenges of this particular environment on the euro is that we just simply don't have any open space here, right? There's really no open space up there. So I take this trend line, copy and paste it up, right? Even if we do end up with an explosive move higher here, I'm really not in a very comfortable position unless I see the market just blow right through, right? If it blows right through, then obviously we have a new channel. We'll look for that tomorrow once we have some more information, right? But assuming we bounce off that high, right, then we know we're looking to use that support level down there, right, as a buying opportunity going back up to retest the high, and we'll just keep using that bull channel, which pretty much acts like a spike in channel, buying the low of that channel tomorrow and using that high as a target. So a lot of variables, again, ahead of tomorrow's non-farm payrolls. Again, euro is definitely a market that is highly susceptible to big moves on non-farm Friday. How to return bearish, strong move down, hold the pullback and go, find that, right, find that hidden channel, and then sell off that hidden channel, right? That hidden channel will be drawn off of the lows in that situation, and they'll look for that sell up off the high, right? That sell up off the high. So very, very simple if we get the move lower, right? If we get that, right? If we get that explosive move lower, strong move down, hold the pullback and go. Again, you'll know it, right? The market will take off the downside as those buyers give up on their positions and become sellers. The sellers would love to go back down to retest that low where they came from today. The buyers would love to go back up and retest that high. Don't forget, tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time. I hope to see you guys tomorrow in the trade room. And we're going to execute this strategy together with all of our advanced members. Speaking of advanced members, we have a great advanced course here at School of Trade. No matter who you are, where you come from, I have helped thousands of traders do this the right way in my lengthy teaching career here at School of Trade. We have beginner, intermediate, and advanced classes here at School of Trade. Doesn't matter who you are, how much experience or little experience you have, we get a great place for you here at SOT. And if you want to learn more about the strategies we use, get a free pass to attend our trade room, don't forget to join that free trial. It's right there on the homepage of schooloftrade.com. If you're on the YouTube channel right now, there's a link in the description of that YouTube video. Don't forget, we open up tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock Eastern time. If you need any help getting in, any help getting registered, right, hit me up on live support on the right-hand side of our website. And don't forget, be careful tomorrow morning, ahead of the news tomorrow morning. Be careful those 5 or 10 minutes after the news comes out. Be well out there. Be nice to each other, will ya? And be here next time. Adios, amigos. Bye-bye for now.